Hi friends, in Planet Earth Dating, it's Sunday, January 13th, 2019. In both the Lynn life and the Jamie body mind, the authorized souls remain only child souls from the deeper, denser dimensions, and all other souls from all other dimensions, as long as the souls are already living by the many rules given to the search for truth community by wiser minds above all of us, and those rules obviously include participating in searches for truth, participating in investigatory processes to come to understand what's actually going on. During the era where this host life was teaching classes to other humans to teach them how to facilitate multidimensional angelically guided energy healing for soul purpose, which was labeled the Lightworker's Healing Method. It's a teachable, learnable art that requires quite a bit of commitment.
That's true.
And changing personally on every level.
That's true.
And what we found is something that was shocking, and we learned this early in the class era. Actually, that's not true. It was probably 3 years into the era of trying to teach it to others. And there was this exercise that was level one, day one, in the morning. It was so early in the curriculum. And the exercise was just, can we discern instructions from our guardian angels that say whether a certain piece of poster board is black or white? Is it black? Is it white? The exercise was getting us listening up and seeing if we could get such a simple yes, no, black, white concept. And it was stunning and confusing to us that people didn't seem to be able to do it.
That's true.
And the input upstairs was, all right, we'll add that to the list of interesting things we need to follow up on. And meanwhile, there are about 1,000 other things on that list. And it will resolve. The answer will come. Just keep going. Just keep going. If you get hung up on that, you're never going to progress through all the other things.
That's true.
And we first noticed that maybe in 2010, summer of 2010. And by the time the instructions from above were don't teach the classes and don't cancel the classes, which were arguing factions.
That's true.
Which was toward the end of 2013.
Oh, that's true.
All the other questions had been resolved. And that was the sticking point. That was the only sticking point in the entire curriculum. We knew how to teach everything else. But people did not seem able to tell what was actually going on at the level of yes, no, up, down, black, white.
That's
and
true.
And that's unfortunate, disturbing. I would say it's disturbing.
That's true.
And lately, we've become aware of a phenomenon that certainly is not new. It's been around. It's a time-honored tradition.
That's true.
Of siding with the villain.
Yeah, that's true.
When there are presences who are clearly the bad guys.
That's true.
Wreaking havoc on the environment. For example, humans are clearly the bad guys. Humans have now destroyed more than 60% of other animal species or animal life on Earth. Whether that's measured by head count or biomass, I don't know.
I don't know.
And probably it's a low ball guess.
That's true.
Based on, and somebody says, what do you base that on? Based on empty skies and empty seas.
That's
what
true.
We would base it on. And empty nature preserves, where you can go out in the middle of a 5,000 acre nature preserve, and there's no discernible life.
That's true.
Which is disturbing. It is. We know these topics are interrelated, this difficulty in discerning black from white, front from back, up from down, yes from no, and the phenomenon of siding with the villain. And somebody's talking about Stockholm Syndrome.
That's true.
Which is a psychological phenomenon where if somebody is taken captive and certain sets of circumstances apply, that the captive will begin to defend the captors.
That's true.
In a court of law, I believe, is what was going on in that particular circumstance. But we'll say, no, they were the good guys.
That's right.
Even when they were clearly not the good guys.
That's right.
But now, to be on the correct side of any argument, when somebody's talking right now and they're saying when the prevailing search is the search to prevail. Oh, I like that.
Yeah, me too.
Then there's not a search for truth.
That's true.
People are just people of all kinds of sentience in all dimensions when they're just defending their position, which is rampant.
That's true.
There isn't an inquiry into what's actually going on, and often sides are taken before there's adequate research into the topic.
That's true.
Clearly, all those deluded Florida Seminoles should have thought it through better before they sided with the Seminoles over the Gators.
That's true.
And this is how everybody feels.
All of us.
Is that me and people like me, me and presences like me, we are the good guys and the other people are the bad guys.
Yeah.
We see this with farmers. We live in a small farming community. These host lives live in a small farming community, and the farmers seem to view nature as the enemy.
That's true.
Which we don't. We view nature as a collaborator.
That's true. And someone's saying again that the point is how to tell a villain from a not villain.
Or even to inquire into it, to have interest into it.
Somebody's saying
many people don't care.
They don't care
that they're siding with the villain. They want to side on the winning. They want to be on the winning team.
That's true.
And what to do when it looks like the villains are winning? Clearly, presences who are on the villain's team should say, wow, this is not what I really want on my karmic record when check out. I need to switch sides and work for the presences who are not the villains.
That's true.
And what we see happening when people speak up about what's clearly villainy, and you could take, for example, the Western medical system
where they torture
old people, and they torture them repeatedly, not solving their problem, just solving it a little bit. And so death by a thousand cuts, these old people to have 5, 10, 15 surgical procedures. And each time, of course, ka-ching, the cash register rings at the hospital and the pharmaceutical lab and the doctor's offices.
Surgical centers.
Everybody's getting paid.
That's true.
And because often it's paid by a third-party insurer, the patient is often willing to participate, or the family is willing to put their elderly relatives through torture so that they can talk at dinner parties with cool medical terms.
Yes, that's true.
And what this does is drive up the costs for everyone to the point that poor children don't have health insurance. And we as a country in North America, we don't have universal health insurance, which is an embarrassment.
That's true.
And really the whole point is what we have is too many doctors.
That's true.
And it's a simple case of supply and demand, and there's an oversupply of doctors, and we should shut down the medical schools for maybe 20 years and let the oversupply dwindle down.
That's true.
And that this is true for humans also. We have an oversupply of humans, and we need to stop breeding humans and let the oversupply dwindle down. For whom is the message, and why do you ask? And what now to sit on the correct side of the debate?
Silale ma we, we ma wa silale ma.